Now we have studied that man in his early stages of life gives more importance to the sensuous pleasures. So after enjoying a lot in the sensuous pleasures, when he gets that boredom, then what happens to a man? He says that existence in this earthly realm must lead a sensitive person to despair. A person who thinks, a sensitive person, automatically, once he gets boredom, that leads to despair. And you know, this despair is inevitable result of individuals having to confront momentous concrete ethical and religious dilemmas as an individual. As an individual, we will be facing a lot of ethical dilemmas, religious dilemmas. So when we are confronting them, automatically we get the despair because we do not find the answer. It is the result of individual having to make himself choices of lasting significance. So lasting significance and a permanent importance ka unde choices enchukone kramam lopala he gets the despair. And Kierkegaard says that this despair is the sickness unto death. Chanipe varuku manam ento untundanta. And it is the central philosophical problem. So philosophy has to answer the problem of despair, the problem of sickness unto death. So that is what is Kierkegaard regards as the problem which the philosophy has to attend. Is there anything in this world or outside it to which the individual can cling to keep from being swept away by the dark tides of despair? No, you know that the man is affected by the dark tides of despair when he gets disillusionment with his sensuous pleasures. So having disillusioned, being swept away by the dark tides of despair, what man tries to do is try to cling to some point so that nadilo kottuku pothunnadu ankonde karra mukka dorikina pattukuntamo em dorikina pattukuntam kottuku pokunda undadaniki. That's what he says. Tides of despair nunchi tattukodaniki, not to be swept away by the tides of despair, what does the man try to do? He tries to cling on to something, and that something he tries to find either in this world or outside this world. And for Kierkegaard, this is the fundamental question. Eventual conclusion is that nothing earthly, ante edaina sare ee prapanchamlo unnadi edi kuda manushini tides of despair nunchi kottukopokunda aapaledu. So nothing in this earth, nothing of this world can help a man from being swept away by the dark tides of despair. Only a subjective commitment to the infinite and to God, whether it is God or infinite or whatever, absolute or whatever it is, only when he believes, when he has a faith in that God, which is not objective but subjective, because he cannot find any proofs for that. It cannot be an objective commitment, it can only be a subjective commitment. It is, which is not based on intellectualizing or theoretical reasoning. So when you try to find proofs, then it becomes intellectualized or theoretical. So he says that beyond the intellectualizing and theoretical reasoning, the commitment, the subjective commitment to the God can only give him relief. Relief of what? Relief from the sickness unto death or despair. So that is what is the theory of Soren Kierkegaard. Being an existentialist, that too who believes in God, he says that in the three stages of life, in the first two he gets the despair, but in the last he finds the solution for that despair. That is religious belief, that is faith, that is subjective truth. Okay.